simulation of spacecraft berthing with a robotic arm. Is Mr. Golubev or Yaskev is here?
This is Andreas Cage.
Perfect.
I'm ready.
Perfect. Then you can start whenever you want.
I can start?
Yes.
You see my presentation?
Yes, we can see that.
Okay. Hello, everybody. My name is Andreas Cage. I'm working for Rocket Space Corporation Energia. My presentation is simulation of spacecraft building with a robotic arm. Building is on-orbit joining of two spacecraft by using space manipulator. The robotic arm mounted on the one spacecraft moves other one to achieve a capture, a primary mechanical connection of the Earth interface. After capture, arm joints are relaxed and the special berthing and docking mechanism retracts spacecraft to reject joining. First berthing was implemented in September 2009. Japanese cargo vehicle HTV was joined with International Space Station ISS by using SSRMS, Space Station Remote Manipulator System. This robot arm is pacing crane, so it has a symmetrical kinematical scheme with seven links. Its base link and end effector have the same design and may switch their functions. Versus spacecraft has a grapple fixture for holding by manipulator, three ropes, on the end effector as well a prop head of grapple fixture and then are attracted for connection. Second berthing was implemented for joining Russian mini research module MRM-1 with FGB port of ISS. Usual docking of this module was impossible because of approach limitation, so it was delivered to ISS by space shuttle vehicle. Full scenario of this operation consists of three general stages. First, shuttle remote manipulated system SRMS extract MRM-1 from cargo bay. Second, SRMS captures and moves the MRM to berthing position. And third, SRMS berths the MRM-1 to FGB port. Slide 4 shows the FGB docking port before berthing and SRMS with MRM-1 in berthing position. Target aiming is located near FGB port because of joining PropCon docking units. SRMS joint angles are included in initial data for dynamic simulation. Different control modes of SRMS may be initiated by robotic workstation, RVS. Approach accuracy necessary for capture is achieved by involving human operator in control loop of robotic arm. Operated use two control handles, left for linear displacement and right for rotation. Handle control signals are interpreted as required linear on angle velocities of aiming TV camera relative to target. Computer recalculates these Cartesian values to arm joint velocities using solution of inverse kinematical problem. In NASA Johnson Space Center, SSRMS robotic workstation is used as a part of software engineering simulator for mission real-time simulation and crew member training. Robotic arm operated use aiming TV camera for minimizing of lateral miss and four round up TV cameras for angle alignment, namely two space shuttle TV cameras from SRMS RIST, Two TV cameras on the space station truss switches by turns. Angle alignment allows isolate a pure lateral miss on target TV image. Initial condition and lower limits of SRMS and the Russian docking system were not coordinated with each other. This was a main problem of MRM berthing. Russian docking system was represented in CES by simplified MAT model. Validation of control procedure developed by CES was implemented by hybrid simulation of Bösing on 6 degree of freedom facility in Rocket Space Corporation Energy. 20 run cases were selected for this purpose. Each run case combined a set initial condition, letter at MGO MIS, with control manner. First part, real-time control cases, RT, corresponded to fine control from approach beginning till capture. Second part, non-real-time cases, NRT, used preliminary appointed max value of axial velocity. Six DOF facility for hybrid simulation consists of moving platform, structure with force measuring system and control computer. Active docking unit and any TV camera are installed on moving platform. Passive unit is mounted on the plate of the measuring system and target is fixed on the structure. Two round-up TV cameras are located on the wall of the test facility room. Three video monitors show images from TV cameras. Two control handles allow control assess RMS MAT model. This model consists of a procedure for solving confounders kinematical problem, digital controller drives model, rigid body chain dynamic equation, and arm stiffness matrix calculate to end effector grip of fixture interface. Input data for SRMS MAT model contains control handle signals and reaction of arm deformation acting on end effector. MRM is the MAT model described by Newton-Euler dynamic equation with taking into account contact forces and reaction of arm deformation acting on the grapple fixture. MRM inertia with SRMS arm stiffness matrix reproduce first six frequencies of mechanical system oscillation. Control computer of test facility integrates dynamic equation and calculates position and velocity of platform hydraulic drives according to docking unit relative position. Used control hardware was too much different from SRMS robotic workstation, but this was compensated by operator adaptive capacity. This slide shows the five times accelerated video of probe head entering into receiving cone during 6DOF test of an RT case with big lateral misalignment. After first contact, probe head slides along cone surface, fall into receiving socket and captured. But in some NRT cases, capture was not achieved because of limited power of arm joint drives. Special software dynamic diagrams was used for post-processing multi-window visualization of Bösing hybrid simulation. Upper window one displays the frame model of the docking unit, kinematics parameter of their relative motion, signal of discrete or analogous sensors of docking mechanism. Window 2 in the center of the diagram shows the configuration of arm and signals of control handles. A more scalable window 3 on the right central part shows relative position of docking units, any TV camera and docking target. The lower window displays contact force or other simulation parameters as a function of time. The vertical central line correspond to current simulation time. Images and parameters of upper and central windows are changed according to this time. Animation is also four times accelerated for this presentation. Next three slides show plots of kinematics and force parameters for an RT case number 322. Max axial closing velocity is specified on third second and by the left control handle. After 10 seconds, this velocity achieved max value. First contact takes place on the 19 seconds. From this point till capture, lateral miss is decreased because of probe contact interaction, but angular miss is increased because of moment of contact force. Capture is achieved on 54 seconds. Contact force is decreased, is increased at the same time, is increased during contact interaction and achieve values more than SRMS load limits. So this NRT case is not acceptable for bursting. Initial angle miss in RT case number 3, real-time control, exceeds the same one in previous NRT case. At first, operator decreases angle miss by series of small control signals on the, by the right control handle. Then, show this three controls. Then he put series of small signals for very slow approach. First contact occur after 360 seconds and capture after 400 seconds. Low level of contact force during real-time control is acceptable for bursting. And conclusions. This bursting hybrid simulation allows make next conclusion. The capture is achieved in all cases with fine control with alignment of docking interface. Contact force are acceptable for active and passive docking unit in all cases. Rough control may be cause of contact loads exceeded the SRMS limit. Fine real-time control make contact loads acceptable for SRMS arm. MRM1 bursting mass simulation on software engineering simulator and its validation by hybrid simulation on SIXDOF allowed make general conclusion about possibility of this operation. MRM1 was burst to a GB port in May 2010. Thank you for attention. That's all.
Thank you very much. Very interesting and very exciting application. Are there any comments from the virtual audience? Right, I don't see any hands. I have a very quick question about, I can see here also in the paper saying that this actually successfully implemented on Orbit on 2010. Is it still operational or is somehow updated for newer space stations, for example, or it's the same operation still going on?
No, we make several we made several hybrid simulation for previous and nearest future space operation. Last hybrid simulation was performed 3 years ago and for nearest on-orbit operation for new Russian model MLM. This operation will be realized maybe in next, maybe after next year.
All right. Then I don't really have any other questions. Thank you very much for the presentation and for your time. If there is anything else from the audience, please let me know.